tray of weapons before him, she says, "Choose, Kapishwar." He selects a maze, immediately at home with its heavy shaft and gleam of eye-stirring limb. The others heft swords, battle axes, spears, bow and arrow. "Your weapons are with you," Vaidehi says. "Safe keep them in your heart." Slim light distills onto their way out. Vaidehi stops at a gate. "Kurukshetra," she says, pointing to it. "It has been fought here every time that history demanded. Not in 18 days, but 18 minutes of sleep every night for centuries." Kapish gazes at the sprawling ground, bedecked with moving clumps of bloodied flesh. Bathed in evening light, these bits of body seem to have some fight left in them. Vaidehi nods. "There are other planes for other wars, Amragedan, but we are not concerned with them for now." Kapish wakes up, coughing. It was early morning. The torrent outside the window makes the dripping quiet. Shafts of lightning dagger through the melting gray sky over dark leaf tree horizon. Thunder follows. Who is he really? Hanuman? He recalls stories his mother told him of Kapishwar, Hanuman, the lord of monkeys from the ancient epic of Ramayan. Wasn't he named after the monkey god because of his appearance alone? Thought Kapish now. Or was there more to it? "You are my little monkey," his mother would say after she had recited enough of the bedtime epic to him. "You will one day grow big enough to rescue Sita from Ravan. You should always help women, okay, Kapi? We are strong, but not against bad men or bad minds." "What really happened to you?" asked Kapish. "The Shanam abducted me to Bombay," said Vaidehi. "When I tried to escape, he killed me. But the earth encroaches and embraces all. She relieves everyone of pain, our mother. She swallowed me, made me whole again, with not a limb cut, not a vein slit, not a wound torn through. She regenerated me. That is the power of the womb, of the earth. She flowers her children, recycles them by holding them into her warm, mesmeric arms. And even those of you who do not meet their end like me will come to this place. Your restlessness, your disbelief with reality, your disillusionments will bring you here. Head splitting like a thousand detonating bombs." Kapish wakes now, squinting against the dawn. His neck trembles with the effort of holding his heavy skull. Were the dreams provoking a greatness out of him? Something he had or perhaps didn't? Power from judgment, instinct and experience was one thing, but being a chosen one? Well, that was different. Was he truly the avatar of Hanuman? Or was he just dreaming big? Today was Ramba's court hearing, and he hurried to keep his date with justice. Silence descends. Tears flow from Kapish's tired eyes. The battle is over. morning, Kapish's head feels as light as a balloon. A month passes. His job as a sleuth now irks him. Things seem too slow. Yet he refrains from going down the fourth stage of sleep, keen on avoiding its slippery pathways. Was it real? Was he even supposed to access it? Is it right to do so again? He should focus on real life and its purpose, who he really is and what he wants to become. Time to take sides, the real, concrete, proof-based ones, not some illogical, ephemeral, dreamlike states. But as the season's last rain pours outside the windows and dims Kapish into a restless daydream, he finds himself wondering if it had indeed been one great delusion. Maybe there is no choice to be made after all.